Hello dear friends, students, today we are going to discuss the second part of our topic, that is the habitat of algae. In the first session we studied regarding the introduction, general characters of algae. So we already discussed that algae is of diverse in habitat occurring all over the world. Okay. So, and you can see it terrestrial, you can see present them in the water, tree trunk and everywhere. So that is the importance of algae, and they are the photosynthetic, or they are the primary producers of our ecosystem, and they play a very important role in controlling global climate change. Okay. So first general character about the habitat of algae means the place where an algae is growing. So in this class I am going to discuss some of the features of the system where algae is growing. Okay. It is common, you can see them in freshwater, in marine, that is in ocean, in estuaries, seashore area, etc. Then tree trunks, majority you can see in the olden tree trunks, bark of the tree, etc. Surface of the trees, then it may be also present in the leaf surfaces also. Okay. Then fallen tips also. Then in the soil, many algae are growing on the surface of soil and just under the soil also. That is in the loamy soil, sandy soil, and all types of soil you can see algae. Then rocks, that's very important. You may be seeing in the running streams, lakes, then in the seashore area, there are huge rocks on which algae are growing. That we already observed thing. Then on the walls, you can see when rainy season comes, your wall of your cement wall, your terraces having algae attached. Then on the courtyards, tiles, etc., you can see the algae growing. Then hot springs, some are adaptable to live in the extreme hot springs also. That's also its important feature. Okay. Then first one is hydrophytes. What is a hydrophyte? Any organism that growing in water is known as hydrophyte, that plants growing in water. Here algae growing in water, there are two categories of aquatic algae, that is benthophytes and planktophytes. What do you mean by benthophytes? Those algae that are attached in water. Okay, may be attached inside water, that may be of rocks, of shells of other organism, or anywhere it is attached. That is known as benthophytes. Example is, two very good example, that two are there in your syllabus, you have to study, is Chaera and Cladophora. Clear? Cladophora is usually observed attached on the shells. Okay. Then planktophytes means they float on water, freely float in the water. And there are different categories. Euplanktophytes means they are never attached. They are always free swimming in water. Then trichoplanktophytes means in the beginning stages they attached, but later they become free. Some examples are, those most of all planktons are belongs to first category. You can have example diatoms, and the some of them are free floating, first then first attached then free floating. Example is Spirogyra. It's very common algae, you studied even your plus two classes. So benthophytes and planktophytes. Planktophytes again classified into euplanktophytes and trichoplanktophytes. Okay. So you can see in the picture the water with free floating and also attached forms. Okay. Then halophytes and epiphytes, other category. Halophytes means salinity or salt water loving groups. So they occur in the saline water. Example is Oscillatoria. Then epiphytes are those present in the living plants and also on the surface of other large huge algae. So some of the epiphytes you can see attached on the grasses and all, but some you can see attached on the large algae. Okay, large macroscopic algae are growing in water. So this smaller algae attached on this large algae, that are also epiphytes. So halophytes, salt loving, Oscillatoria, then this also seen in freshwater Oscillatoria, both condition, epiphytes are also present. Clear? Then next, edaphophytes means those growing in the terrestrial. So first half we studied hydrophytes, second half we studied halophytes and epiphytes, and third we are going to discuss in edaphophytes, means they are growing in the terrestrial side. So two groups are the saprophytes and the cryptophytes. Saprophytes means they are known as surface algae, means usually observe on the wet soils, surface of some parts, etc. Example Vaucheria. Then cryptophytes means they are growing inside the soil. Example is Nostoca and Anabina. They are present inside the soil. One is outside the soil or attached on the wet soil. Example is Nostoca and Anabina. What I am giving the example is all you have to study in your syllabus. So saprophytes, surface algae present in wet soil. Cryptophytes inside the soil. One is Vaucheria, another one is Nostoca and Anabina. Okay? Then aerophytes. What is aerophytes? Aerial side. Means not in the air. It is on the upper part of the plants. That is usually present on the leaves of the tree. You can call it as epiphyllophytes. Epi means on the, phyll means leaf. So epiphyllophytes upon leaves of trees. One very good example is Trendipolia. Then epiphlophytes means they are on the bark of the tree. Okay, epizoophytes on the body of animals. Lithophytes means on rocks and walls. Okay, so these are the category. Aerial means not on the surface of soil but above the soil. That means part of the tree or part of the animal or somewhere else. Epiphyllophytes, epiphlophytes, epizoophytes and lithophytes. Clear? So these are the photographs showing. In the first, here you can see this is the tree trunk and on its surface what is present? Algae. Okay. Then this is a leaf where you can see the algae attached. Okay. Clear. Cryptophytes. Another extreme case means algae growing in ice and snow. They cause red snow, yellow snow and green snow. Some examples are. Very common one is Chlamydia monas. Different species are there. Some of its species growing in fresh water. Some are in other area or habitat also. But very few among them present in the cryptophytes. So, another last and very important part is symbionts. You may know about lichens. Lichens means association of algae and fungi. So, such a type of association, the algae actually photosynthesize and food provided to fungi. Fungi in turn provide water and moisture. So they are together and in a symbiosis live, mutually related. They are mutually benefited condition. So algae are one among them. Then in certain gymnosperms, roots also having some algae attached. Example, cycas. Cycas is a gymnosperm plant. Its root having a special type of roots. Inside the some algae are living. Okay. Then in the pteridophytes also some ferns, you may be heard about Azolla. So in its leaves also some of the algae are growing. So algae may be in association with some other organism, both mutually benefited condition. That group is known as what? Symbionts. The process phenomenon is symbiosis. Okay. Then endozoophytes. So inside the body of some animals, zoos and the lice an example growing in sponges. But may be confused. In corals, inside corals also so many organisms, algae, planktons are living. Okay, so that's also one category. Here it is inside the body of the sponges and algae is living. That is endozoophytes. Okay, then parasites. You know, in the case of algae also there are some groups that are parasites, usually occurring in plants. You know, tea leaves. When you observe tea leaves, you can see some red spots in the tea leaves. That are due mainly because of some algae known as Cephalurus is an example of that algae that cause red rust of tea. So algae is also parasite. Some algae are also parasitic forms. So in algae there are parasitic forms, symbiotic forms, epiphytic forms, so on. Okay. So I think that is very important part we finished. The last fluviatile algae means algae occurring rapidly flowing water. Means they can withstand in such a running water, mountain waterfalls, etc. That term is fluviatile algae. Example is Eulothrix. Then, so I think these are this much about the habitats. So, terrestrial, aquatic, then aero, three category, halophytes, epiphytes. then endozoophytes, parasites, symbionts, then running fast growing streamy water also. So this much regarding the habitat of algae. From this questions may be usually arising to write brief notes, short answer type, etc. And also while asking questions, essay on general characters, you can have this part also, different habitats and examples. So that's all for today. Thank you.